This is a story for anyone who's ever made a list of things to do and not done them. A story for anyone who's ever had a dream that died, made a wish that didn't come true. In short, this is a story for everyone.
There's something about the human spirit that when you accept challenge and work on it and have deadlines and capture your potential, it's astounding what you can do.
Meet John Goddard.
Little Alfalfa is a treat.
He's got a wife, 5 kids, 2 dogs, a cat, and a horse. No news there.
Sweet old horse.
Oh, and one more thing. He's flown planes, jumped from planes, climbed atop elephants, climbed atop mountains, kayaked down the Congo, and, well, the list goes on and on. Did we say list? Oh, yeah. You see, there's this thing about a list.
Well, it's been a fascinating life.
And a well-planned one. You see, one day when John was 15, a friend of his dad said he regretted never having done the things he wanted to when he was John's age.
It hit me so strong that I pulled out a yellow Lego pad and started writing the things I was going to do before dying because they were just buzzing around in my head as fantasies.
127 fantasies, to be exact. Soon there were more, then more still. Today there are nearly 400 of them on the list. Fantasies like number 40, learning to fly. That's Goddard flying a fighter jet. Fantasies like number 82, skydiving, as he did here over the California desert. And fantasies like number 25, climbing Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania. To Goddard, it seems the unfilmed life may not be worth living. His film has been rolling for a lifetime. Much of it has been spent on top of the world.
You've climbed many of the world's tallest mountains.
Probably a dozen.
The Matterhorn?
Matterhorn.
Mount Rainier?
Mount Rainier.
Mount Fuji?
Fuji.
Mount Vesuvius?
Vesuvius.
Mount Everest?
No.
He says he couldn't save enough money for an Everest climb. When Goddard isn't going up mountains, he's kayaking down rivers. Goddard spent 6 months exploring the Congo River. He also kayaked down the Nile. That was goal number one for an astonishing 9 months and wrote a book about it.
Many of the things on your list are not just adventures, they're education. I mean, here, read the works of Shakespeare, Plato.
Shakespeare, Plato.
Aristotle.
Yeah, yeah. Aristotle. Yeah.
Dickens, Thoreau.
Well, I've had a long time to do those things, John.
You didn't stop there. Poe, Rousseau, Bacon, Hemingway, Twain, Burroughs. How did you find the time to do all these things?
You plan ahead. And when you write down a goal, that's a commitment. You don't just let it lie there.
Mm-hmm.
If you have any ego strength at all, you say, I'm going to really do that. And then you save money, you prepare, you take instruction, and you do it.
Okay, here we go.
All kidding aside, John Goddard, who every year leads a large group on a nature hike, is not a man who wastes a lot of time wasting time. And when we asked him what great adventure he had yet to accomplish, the answer turned out to be dog sledding. So the man whose motto is, to dare is to do, to fear is to fail, let us join him as he put yet another accomplishment in the books.
Most people say, someday I'm going to do that, and they end up, if only I had done that. And I believe in taking control of your life and making it really important and have some substance and meaning to it.
See, this is called white-knuckling it. Not out of fear, but out of effort.
It looked like it was hard work there at some point.
Well, you have to balance and shift your weight back and forth and keep the sled from tipping and keeping in alignment with the dogs, but it's a joy.
Still, Goddard's daring do has come at a price. Although he's happily married for the third time, and he admits marriages 1 and 2 may have been a casualty of his ambition. And when he made his remarkable trip down the Congo River from source to mouth, he and his closest friend, Jack Yowell, hit some vicious rapids. Yowell's kayak flipped over, and he drowned.
But before you judge John Goddard too harshly, remember, he really has explored a number of the world's greatest rivers, climbed some of its highest mountains. There's film of it. By anyone's reckoning, he's lived a life of adventure, wonder, and accomplishment. And by reaching for his goals, John Goddard has inspired others to reach for theirs.
And let me tick off a few of the things that have enriched my life.
When he's not tempting fate, he's trying to tempt students with what he's done.
Learning to fly, skydive, hang glide, rock climb, drive a race car, water and snow ski, surf, scuba dive, read the Bible from cover to cover, become an Eagle Scout.
And urging them to dream as big as he does.
Many of us make up lists when we're 15, and frequently we give up on them by the time we're 16. How were you able to hang on to your dreams?
Wonderful role models and setting deadlines. I'm going to do this by the end of the summer. I'm going to do this by the end of next year. And I never give up on a dream. Even going to the moon has never been given up.
Did I just hear you want to go to the moon?
Of course.
Significantly, though he's checked off most of his goals, there's one left from his original list, the very last one. And it may be the most important goal of them all.
Tough question for you. Goal number 127, live to see the 21st century. It's not far away.
Not far away. I think I'm going to make it.
I understand you're fighting cancer.
Still fighting it, but I'm well ahead of the game because I'm now several years over the expectancy that originally was diagnosed. I think Annie Oakley had done it one time.
In the end, Goddard says, the moral of his list and a lifetime of goal setting is that life is a daily miracle, that we live in the best time in human history, a time when with planning, preparation, and a little discipline, the ordinary person can do extraordinary things.
Life is meant to be lived fully, deeply, optimistically, without hanging on to the baggage of the past, with no fear of the future, to live each day completely.